Hello and welcome to the SSCIT weekly broadcast. As Nepeta mentioned last week, it is I, Shonko, who will be casting these games this week. Don't worry if you miss him though, you will encounter him next Sunday, and from that point on we will be alternating every week who has the cast. With that being said, let's start with the first recommended game, which is Seda vs. Microwave. As you can see, it's a pretty standard opening for Seda, at least. Supply depot followed by a barracks, I think. Barracks and gas. And let me just slow it down because I'm just getting used to live casting and, quite frankly, the replay viewer. As Nepeta mentioned, I'm a software developer myself. I actually develop Brood War bots, not very good ones at the moment. Maybe I will cast the game a little bit later. But I intend to bring a unique perspective, or at least a different perspective than Nepeta's, to this week's cast and every cast from now on. Okay, we see some number of Zerglings just going across the map. I think it was scouted before, or maybe this map has limited spawn positions, I don't know. I should look that up. And oh, attacking the expansion here, but that was not a command center. Was that a bunker maybe? I don't know. We might never find out. Let's look at the army tab. Seda has one vulture and chasing down the Zerglings quite nicely. So being about developer perspective, I might have some insights about why bots do things, why bots don't do things, and generally why do they seem to be so stupid. Not speaking of any particular bot, of course. Okay, so Seda. He is building supplies and not much else. Defending the natural expansion, I see. Beat a bunker, maybe. And two missile turrets. Meanwhile, Microwave is just doing nothing, it seems. Oh, Hydralisks. On the natural and the lurkers. Oh, I missed that for a moment. Nice leapfrogging action from the lurkers, actually. It's rare to see that, to be honest. Usually players just bunch up their lurkers and unburrow with them at the same time. Which is understandable if you're a human, but for a bot, a leapfrogging micro actually can be executed quite well, as Microwave exemplifies it here. Look at me and using my fancy words. And a little bit back and forth. Let me just slow this down. No tanks sieged up from Seda yet. They are just rolling around, enjoying the joyride, spinning around. I mean, I would in a 60-ton vehicle, or how much they weigh. And are those vultures stuck and can't get out, or just don't want to? Maybe it's not. They are not on duty yet. Yeah, I don't know. The lurkers seems to go back and forth. And now the developer perspective I spoke of. Usually this kind of things happens when the units don't have vision at that point, which my cursor is. They wander in the vision and they decide to retreat back to a safe distance. And they don't really store that information, so they just wander back, rediscover the same thing, and do it again. You can see this dancing back and forth for a lot of bots. I'm entirely not sure that's exactly what's happening here, but it is an explanation. Okay, looks like... Oh, a scan just went off. Looks like Microwave is gathering its army. His army? I don't know what gender bots are. Let's just go with neutral. And oh, that might not be a good idea because you have detection and yeah, you are very dead. I was wandering into range. Let me speed this up a little. Gathering the army, wandering into bunker range. Yeah, that wasn't a good idea. Seda seems to be still stuck. That's a nice alliteration. And Hydra's wandering in. Lings doing some damage. Oh yes. And why are they retreating, I wonder? There is no actual threats here. I mean, maybe it's sieged? No, the tanks aren't sieged in the backyard. So, yeah, I'm gonna call it definitely stuck. Yes. Poor vultures and mech units are being stuck in behind this missile turret that was placed somewhat in an unfortunate position. And Hydra's just spitting the bunker away. Well, not entirely. They could have done that. And you see them retreating every now and then. I wonder what kind of combat simulator Microwave uses, actually. Because it seems to me that the Hydras and the Zerg armies clearly in overwhelming force, yet they seem hesitant to attack. Okay, a little bit dancing back and forth. And oh, Seda just snuck out of base, but Microwave found it and putting a quick end to that. Goliaths are just very scared of these 3 or 4 mutas, I don't know how many. Someone with a better eye could count them, I guess. And speed and die. But another sneaky SCV just got out. I wonder if there is a land pet. Oh yes, there is a ramp actually, so they can easily sneak out and try to form a new base. It seems like Seda just tries to do the same thing again and again, and eventually succeeds it seems. And this Hydra and Zergling army, I believe it's quite enough to bust this natural around here, but they seem hesitant to do so. I don't know why that is. Oh yeah, actually I had Microwave's author, Micro, on my podcast, which is the Undermine podcast, which is all about StarCraft AI development. Well, Brood War AI development. So if you're not familiar with that, let me just advertise myself a little here. So yeah, maybe I will ask him next time what's these poor little Zerglings and spiny spitty things doing here. Oh, a science vessel just lurking around the corner. Actually, two of them. Did they do anything useful? Or did they use any ability around here? It seems no. Okay, let me speed this up because this is just... Oh. Yes, yeah, something is happening. Mostly a lot of shots on the Mutalisks. The Zerglings. Oh, and with destroying this missile turret, Microwave just enabled Seda to go and roll out and mobilize the war machine. Oh, yeah, that wasn't a wise decision. You can see Seda mining up the area in the natural and sieging up the tanks, forming a good old Terran deadball. The army seems gathering around here and being a little hesitant. I wonder what kind of function these overlords serve, as they seem to be just hovering around. Maybe detection, yeah, definitely detection. But it seems to me that every group of units, the Zerglings and the Hydras, has overseeing overlord. Oversight lord or something. Maybe he's their boss. Are overlords made actually? I don't know. And this command center just tries to float away, but to no avail. The mutalists are faster and can spit things on it. Awful lot of Zerg attacks rely on spitting on things. That's some food for thought. And I think we can call the GG here. Even with that missile turret blocking, this game very clearly went to Microwave. It's no wonder he has 1, 2, 3, 4 bases, and a fifth just started plopping down, and yeah, congratulations Microwave. And another game for Microwave versus Seda. It's the same map, the same setup, and even the same positions. I'm gonna speed this up a little, because I suspect it will turn out similar, but I didn't actually watch these games before, so anything can happen. Yes, similar opening it seems. Gas, barracks, supply depot, another supply depot maybe? No, a factory. Oh, quick factory from Seda. Microwave with the expansion and a sunken colony and extractor has a spawning pool and Hyroden already. I wonder if he will make another set of lurkers. Watchers already mining up the entrance of the natural. Let's see what happened. Let me slow this down. Oh, lurkers got killed by mine hits. Yeah, I'm not that enthusiastic about mine hits as Nepeta is. I'm sorry about that. I just acknowledge them like a pleb. But let's see what happens. Vultures just popping in and out. Hydras gathering yet again in the front of the natural. And even the blocking missile turret isn't exactly the same. I suspect this will play out somewhat similarly as the previous match did. Let me speed this up, because yeah, pretty much the same thing is happening. Is there sneaking out? No, no sneaking out. Is there any new bases? Oh, sorry, I lost a little action here. Gathering some Hydras, third base down for Microwave, macroing nicely. Oh, another two macro hatches. Yeah, it's just having more stuff than the enemy. Generally a good strategy in StarCraft. I suspect, as you can see, more resources for Microwave. Less army though, but that's a little bit misleading, I think, because he has vastly more production. And Seda is starting to mine out. And you can do one base Terran pretty long, as Crazio demonstrated for a long time, or Hellpen or Iron, but eventually you will run out of resources and then you get a problem. Okay, bunkers seem to be more effective when there are Marines inside it, but maybe that's just my opinion. Nicely trickling in the link train. Oh, the supervising overlords just arrived. And I think with that the invasion just can begin. Little bit mucking about. I don't know, that two missile turrets does not seem to be that threatening for a ground army. Oh yes, that two marines and the bunker. The idea was good, but generally you have to wait until the bunker completes. Sorry. Yeah, one marine's just scaring away all the Zerg army. He must be so proud of himself. Come on, Microwave, just attack. Maybe he's waiting for overwhelming force and just begins to attack them. It's strange. Seems to me that there are some points the units are trying to gather. Maybe Microwave is spamming commands a little bit too much, but I'm not judging here. Yeah, again, the useless science vessel. I mean, let's give it a chance to shine, but yeah, it probably won't. Goliaths versus Mutalisks. A few Scourges flying in and out, not doing anything. And the ground army is slowly gathering and destroying the natural. Oh, let's slow this down. Eventually they break in and the Zerglings. Oh, that's for some nasty mine hits. So, rest in pepperoni Zerglings, but yes. Again, Zerg victory has been just achieved. Yeah, it pretty much played out the same way as the previous one did. Let's go to the next game, which is a crazy one with Banana Brain versus Mad Mix Protoss. It has been going on for 32 seconds at this point, but I think you can forgive me for not broadcasting that. I mean, you missed a lot of good drone mining action, which is the best part of the game, but sorry, I'm just cruel to the audience now. Okay, mining up, pylon in the natural, not much going on for Banana Braid. It's a little bit hard to see the brown in the minimap, but no matter. A forge? Oh no, maybe a forge first expand. Or maybe not, I don't know. Walling off nicely. Well, not too nicely, but an attempt was made. And a zealot from Banana Brain. And that looks like a pylon. And some more zealots. Okay, let's speed this up. Oh, something wandered in. I think it was a scouting probe. Let's just wind back the wheel of time. And yes, it was a scouting probe. Carrying some minerals nonetheless. That mineral will be never in any player's bank anymore. Okay, some defensive cannons for Madlings Protoss. Nice arrangement. Gateway, and these are either pylons or cannons, or some mix of both, I feel. Guess at the natural, Banana Brain still hasn't expanded and still didn't have anything other than zealots. And, well, workers are a little bit more for Madmix, but Madmix does not have an army. Let's see how this plays out. I mean, this is a scary amount of zealots. Yeah, if you leave your pylon undefended, then it will be destroyed. And nicely rolling up the cannons, but... Oh, why are you retreating? You got this. It's 6, 7, a lot of zealots, and 10 actually. Yeah, going back. Oh, why did you do that, Banana Brain? You had this. But nonetheless, he is returning to the base, gathering strength, still hasn't expanded. But, maybe, yes, it just did. And oh, Stargate, 2 Stargates, big telescope thing, fleet beacon. So it might be carriers, who knows? Maybe just scout rush. Yeah, probably not. And another pylon, probably. What's the function? I wonder. And just gathering the zealots. Bandmix seems to have the better economy, 2 bases and almost 40 workers. And Banana Brain just 25 workers, but has actually an army, which it is not using at the moment, so eh. Templar Archives done. Anything else? Oh, 3 gateways now. Another pylon. This pylon seems to pop down to just random positions, even outside of the base. Maybe that's just not the best choice for pylon placement. And let's look at the upgrades tab. Oh yeah, Dragoon's sight range for Banana Brain and leg speed for zealots and interceptor capacity. And oh yeah, that's a pretty important upgrade. Army wise, there is 1 carrier from Madmix gathering here nicely, and a zealot somewhere, oh, right here, just chilling about. And oh, the army is on the move for Banana Brain. And let's see what. Let's speed this up a little. Oh, that zealot is just wandering about. And the exposed pylons, of course, get destroyed. And cannons rolled up nicely. 2 carriers are on the move, but not doing much, I think. With 6 interceptors, your options are somewhat limited. Let's take a look at the research. Oh, is that mind control? I see. Do we have a Dark Archon in this game? Not yet. Looking at the army tab. Oh, some Dark Templars somewhere from Banana Brain. Oh, there. And the Dark Archon. Oh, that will be exciting. Meanwhile, 5 carriers have already gathered in this base. Well, not in this base, obviously, but somewhere around here. Oh, there, they are on the map. I just missed the battle. Dragoons trying to do something, but two dragoons versus five carriers, well, three, and in this place, it's not a good outlook. Oh. And just mercilessly slaughtering the zealots who can't do anything. But oh, wait, there is the Dark Archons. Maybe they will steal the carriers. Come on, let's steal it. If they don't get killed before that. Oh, three Dark Archons. Definitely this is a counter strategy. And not much is going on. Drones dying. Everything just dying. An observatory just finished that I feel don't have much effect on the outcome. More drones lolling in, God knows from where. And will we see a mind control? I'm so excited. So does this Dark Archon in the corner. Oh, and yes, we did. Took one carriers from Banana Brain. Still five more for Mad Mix, but... oh, another one stolen. And the odds are turning. The odds are turning. Maybe. Yes, three carrier left for Mad Mix. And I don't know, these carriers take a lot of damage too. Damage down, Whittle down, and yes, it seems Banana Brain's tactic has played off. And the two mind control carriers are happily chasing away the third one, which belongs to Mad Mix. Well done. I don't think many bots use mind control. And I think maybe Mad Mix should pay more attention to Dark Archons when using a carrier. I mean, he had pretty much time to damage them down. But oh well, you can't just prepare for anything. As Nepeta used to say as a disclaimer, I'm not hating on any bots. I think the authors are doing a tremendous amount of work, and as a bot author myself, I know how much of an undertaking is that, so please just take it as constructive criticism on my part. So yes, no hate for bot authors. We love their work, and please continue doing it. And yes, maybe if your bot is missing some capability, just try to implement it. Yeah, but I know, as a wise man once said, code is long and life is short, so you simply don't have time for everything you want. And Banana Brain's carrier fleet is actually bigger than Mad Mix's right now, and looking at the base, he didn't make a single one. So with six stolen carriers, the army is on the move. Oh yes, there is a reaver crawling about and chasing down some zealots. Nice base in the corner, unbothered and mining. Well, actually, Mad Mix has three more bases that are just mining heavily. That's quite a lot of economic advantage. And he's still producing carriers, which might be an unwise move in reflection of the previous events. Oh yeah, another thing bot's not very good at, just intuition type things. If my carriers get stolen, don't make any more of them. Yeah, that's something that's obvious to a human, but pretty hard to describe in code terms. And until you actually encounter it and did not think of it, you have basically no way of telling your bot just that. And let's look at the army tab. The carrier count is about equal, but Banana Brain has more interceptors on his side, where the carrier side. And it is crazy, I don't really see which interceptor belongs to who, but Banana Brain seems to be winning and pushing upwards on and on. And what's in the production? Yeah, more carriers. Yeah, how well that will turn out for you, I wonder. An Arbiter for Banana Brain. And this carrier battle is just seems to be going on forever. Oh, another couple of mind controls. Awesome. Carrier count is 9 for Banana Brain. Some High Templars for support. More emotionally at this point, I feel, but yeah, they are there. And just rolling up the base, killing all the pylons, the river doing some good work. While invisible, not that it matters a lot for cannons, but still, storming the cannons, yeah, that won't do you any good, because storm is famously not affecting buildings, but still, I feel the cannon wasn't the primary target of this engagement. And yeah, Banana Brain losing some carriers, but do not care, because they were free. And yeah, thanks Madmix for making carriers for me. Some storms going on, not really bothering either the carriers or interceptors. The last cannons falling, and yeah, now one is happily throwing away the blue balls at the carriers to not to little effect. And yeah, I think that's the GG for Banana Brain, but let's just see it play out. Nicely rolling up the bases. I feel Madmix is somewhat restarting the production, but obviously not very big advantage. Dark Archon just derping around. Maybe that's not the best place for you, buddy. Vicious storms going on to God knows what. Another base for Banana Brain. Another couple of Dark Archons. Yeah, that's a good thing. Natural mind out. Main base mind out. So, 3 mining bases for Banana Brain, 3 mining bases for Madmix, but absolutely no army. I mean, 2 army counts somewhere. I think this is the GG. Let's just speed it up. Rivers just plopping their scarabs at the cannons, and yeah, it's the end. Very well played, Banana Brain, and yeah. More Dark Archon usage is always welcome. GG. Okay, let's go into the next game, which is another recommendation, a Zerg versus Zerg, and everyone knows that Zerg are the best, at least that's my opinion. And let's see, it's Kill All versus Brian Weber. Let me just speed up the initial stages, as they are pretty much the same every game, I mean, except when pretty quick rushes happen, which is rare and also boring. And mining up, making drones, and that's a spawning pool, probably. Yeah, I don't know. Let's just wait for it to complete, and then we can tell. And looking at the rankings, Kill All is in the middle of the pack. I will show some rankings after the match plays out, and Brian Weber is also in middle to low positions, I feel. Oh yeah, it's got a 30% win rate versus Kill All with a 56% win rate, which is actually pretty good. And Kill All is a student bot, at least playing in the student division, and Brian Weber is probably not. So, with that in mind, let's see how this plays out. That's gonna be some big building, not a defensive one. Maybe a macro hatch, I don't know. No, that is the macro hatch. In the meantime, Brian Weber has a Hydrodan. No any significant army. Oh, and he expanded to his natural. Very nice. Lings are going scouting. An overlord from Killall is scouting the map. And more Lings are mucking about. These early Ling versus Ling battles are a very great place to practice your Zergling micro. Well, don't practice in it by running into sunken colonies, I guess. And yeah, Killall Zerglings is wisely retreating. then coming back and waiting for his buddies. Meanwhile, the economy is building up from Brian Weber. An evolution chamber, nice. Maybe this is a part of a walling off, I don't know. Maybe it's just a random placement. And more sunken colonies. And this, I feel, it will be either a hydralisk dam or... no, an evolution chamber. No hydras for kill all as of yet. Okay, in the middle of the map, having a little siesta, Brian Weber's armies. Yeah, and catching a few straylings, but this base is pretty well defended and the Sunkens have no mercy for the wandering inserlings. Spitting on the Overlord and killing it in the process, very nice. And I feel, oh, Brian Weber just expanded to a third base while Killall is still on one. I feel that in itself should be a deciding factor. Let me speed this up because it seems to be a lot of just mucking about and collecting resources. Yeah, Brian Weber has a lot of minerals in the bank, and that's generally not a good sign. At this stage of the game, I mean. And there is a lurker. Oh, and did it get killed? No, it's still alive. Now it got killed. And the lurker egg? Maybe that's not the best place for it, but who knows. The Zerling can't really kill it as lurker eggs have decent armor and HP. And after that, oh yeah, there is detection, so just wait for it to hatch and... oh, going outside of detection range. Well, not quite, but A for effort. And Brian Weber seemed to have just more stuff at this point, which is, as I mentioned before, seems to be the crux of this game. Dealing with a natural and a quick and cruel way. And oh, Lings are just stationed at the ramp. I wonder if that's intentional, because the ramp gives you an edge. If you're standing on a ramp, enemy units have a miss chance against you, if you didn't know that. And yeah, so probably not intentional, just staying outside, just outside of some threat range. Meanwhile, let's take a look at Brian Weber's base. Two hatches in the third base, a spire, a lot of units just streaming on. Let's see at the upgrades. Oh, Brian Weber has a lot of them by Killall. As exactly none. And yeah, I feel I have a guess how this will play out. Brian Weber is taking a fourth base now. Oh, fifth actually. And sixth. And just sieging it. And taking its sweet time. Oh, there are some Mutalisks about, which seem to be hesitant, not even grouped up, so the Mutalisk micro has something to be deserved, and trying to attack the Hydras but changing their mind every now and then, and I feel that's the not the path to victory. Lurker getting killed. Yeah, if there is an Overlord about, then lurkers are not that effective, but this big army could easily just stomp down with this base. Let's speed it up and maybe wait for it to happen. Oh, there is another base here, and it's from Brian Weber, so he has almost all the bases in the map. Has an insane amount of minerals, and let's speed it up while Killall is just mining out while making hatcheries. Yeah, probably not something you want to do. There was some engagements here. A lot of units got killed. Let's go back because we missed that. So yeah, Mutalisks are going in. And now the micro is looking good and just absolutely devastating this number of Zerlings, while the Hydras are not doing much against that. But eventually the Zerglings just move in and start to rip up the sunken colonies. And the Mutalisks follow, but the Zergling damage is insane. And I feel in the grand scheme of things this won't matter much. I mean, yeah, as mentioned, Killall has basically mined out, trying to take a base, but with this many Zerglings about, it's not a good proposition. And a lot of Zerglings again, a lot of Fling lives are getting wasted. Someone should do something about these Mutalisks. I mean, Killall can't just remake them, he has no money in the bank. He has no economy at all, and eventually the Zerglings just wander in and absolutely slaughter these dumb hovercrabs in the top right corner, or top left, that is. And yeah, eventually, if you have all the resources in the map, even a base here and here, you have all the time in the world to just make as many units as you like and kill everything. Yeah, this has been a little bit dumb game. I think Brian Weber is very hesitant to engage, and this Overlord flocking movement is actually interesting. I think this is some kind of detection or maybe a scouting thing, when you just cover the map in equidistant Overlord Dig and have detection on as many places at once as you can, or something like that. Or maybe they just don't like each other and just try to avoid it, avoid each other, but to no avail. Yeah, who knows. And this base is, I feel, no longer standing, or not much longer standing. And yeah, that's the GG. Next up, there is something special for you to this week, which is a pro player called Chobo Swaggins in this game, but actually he's jealous on Team Liquid, and you can check out his Twitch on twitch.com/trappedinc address, which I will provide in the description, because I have a little bit of an accent and you might not have understood that correctly. So it is trappedinc, as in the letter C. With that, let's see what's up. So Chobo Swaggins, which I will be just calling for the Zerg player for simplicity's sake, is playing against Halo, which is actually how Pan's bot's name. I bet you didn't know that. And these games were broadcast on Twitch, actually, but from Jealousy's perspective, and he was live commentating the whole thing. So check that out, I think it's very interesting. But with this replay, we can see both sides at once, and I think that's very, very helpful for us. So, scouting is going on for Haupen, or Halo. I will be calling it alternatively one of the two names. Jealous is not doing anything much about that. Spawning pool done, and in the meantime, a quick proxy barracks in the middle of a map, and just going on and building. Is that a bunker? Is it bunker rushing? Is help? Oh no, the Zerglings have just come out. And will that marine? Oh yeah, that marine will enter the bunker. That was nicely done. And another marine just basically scouting and poking the bear, running back into the barracks. I think that should be pretty annoying for a human player, which it was, and that we know that for a fact. And more marines streaming in. Oops, sorry. And you can see the vast APM difference between a bot and a human here. I mean, 234 it was. It's pretty high for a human. At least it's not low, I know. And yes, some zerglings are streaming in and trying to attack Haupan's main base. And it seems they are succeeding. The SCVs are kind of defending, but not all of them, and they just get slaughtered. Or do they? No, they don't. Yes, they are. So I think that's mostly it. And let's just wait for this to finish. Another base taken for Jealous. The barracks in the middle are just standing sadly. The bunker is still firing. I don't know what's that about. That maybe, yeah, that might be a mistake, and Jealous just realized it. Okay, Morlings streaming back and just defeating the last base. And yeah, that's the GG. And as you can see, the bots have some things that are easier for them or can be done better by a bot. In this case, it was some micro and quite well executed bunker opening, I feel, but then the zerglings just ran around and destroyed the main base. Oh well, maybe next time. Let's check out another thing, which is still the same player, but this time it's against Purple Wave. And as usual, let me speed up the initial stages. Now he's playing Terran. And this... I feel this replay might have been problematic. Okay, let's just jump into the next one. And this time it's versus Locutus, and don't worry, it's the same player playing Zerg. And yeah, I meant to increase the speed, not decrease it. Just gathering strengths. I did not see this match before, so I'm as excited as you are. And scouting, is there scouting going on? I saw something. Oh no, that's just a pylon for Locutus. And what I suspect is a forge, but who knows. And Jealous is already expanding, sending an overlord to maybe scout. Oh yes, and it was a forge. Not much surprise there. No army. This is probably a spawning pool. Not much as it can be. And another building, and that's a pylon, and that's either a nexus or a gateway, but no, yeah, that's most likely a nexus. No, that's a cannon. Maybe a wise choice. And I suspect that will be the gateway. Scouting probe. Unbothered. Some units are in the making, and of course they are zerglings. Meanwhile, gas production is getting up to speed. Locutus, nice wall off. No units as of yet. And Jealous has only one pair of zerglings somewhere around the map. And oh, he's expanding into a third base. Nicely done. Yeah, the zerglings are trying to chase down the scouting probe to have not much success. Yeah, that's not just a problem for bot versus broad games, it seems, but bot versus human ones as well. Two zerglings are scouting. They probably didn't see the cannons. Oh yes, they didn't. One gets killed. The other one just stays there and be horrified. And an overlord is streaming in. Three bases for Zerg. Very nicely done. No guess at the second or the third as of yet. And I feel that will be either a hatchery. Yeah, that's most likely will be a hatchery. And yeah, another hatchery. And Jealous is just macroing hard. Three versus two bases, which is still winnable for the Protoss, don't get me wrong. And we are quite early. Let's look at the army tab. And one corsair, that's interesting. I mean, there are some exposed overlords, and Jealous could get in trouble. Two corsairs for Locutus and five goons. And if anything, Locutus is known for its excellent goon micro, so this will be interesting. But there are defensive hydras, so I feel this attack won't be the last. this delicate goon dance that Locutus does, that is when he's not surrounded, but very wisely he's retreating and just last one goon. I think that's acceptable in this scenario. And just ranging the Zerglings, and goon range is done, so does Hydra range, so not much advantages here. And generally when you trade goons for Hydras, economically the Hydras tend to win. I don't know if that's true in this case. Hydra's retreating very wisely. Why would they be exposed? And Locutus is just mining up, making a dragoon every now and then, and slowly losing these three in the frontier. Still three bases for Jealous. And yeah, pretty much a standstill at this point. Let's check Locutus what he's doing. That might be just another gateway. It's such a shame that, oh yes it is, that we can't see when the gateway is producing. Retreating a little, dancing with the Hydras, I think trading on equal terms. I mean, there are more Hydras, but Goonzer seem to be holding up well, getting pushed, but when the Hydras reached Locutus's base, they just fizzle out. But in the meantime, more goons are streaming in, bases are getting nicely saturated, some serious building is going on here, and yeah, two more buildings which are morphing on the third base. I don't know, an evolution chamber, maybe another one. Oh yes, this one here. So Jealous is just teching up, upgrading. Let's look at the upgrades tab. Not much going on as of yet. Zergling speed done, Hydra speed and range, Overlord transporting capacity. So will we see drops? We might see, we might just see drops. In the meantime, Locutus quietly expanded to this third base and happily macroing and mining away. Locutus is having more success keeping its money down than Jealous, which is no wonder, because these goon incursions demand a lot of attention from the human player. This is one thing that bots definitely have more of. They have basically infinite attention, and humans have a very finite amount of that. And Corsairs just picking up or trying to pick up the Overlords, or just pick them for a fight, not pick up, that would be hard for them. Although, if they believe they can do anything. And nice attack on the third base of Locutus, but the Hydras just get all killed. And the Goon Ball is forming, which is something you should beware if you play against Locutus. Oh, one Goon just got killed in the third base. These Overlords in some serious business, and a fourth base just got found by Locutus. Let me slow this down a little. Oh yes, and another two bases for Locutus I just missed. It seems like Jealous is in trouble, and economically and statistically that both seems to be true. And if you just look at the map, saturation is also looking better for Locutus, and yeah, the goons are just absolutely everywhere and demanding attention. And yeah, they are killing the last of the Hydras. They seem to be always in the right place and in right numbers. Every now and then a Hydra ball gathers and rolls up the goon groups, but then again you get some other goon squad in some other place. Oh, sorry about that. An Archon getting mercilessly and needlessly killed, but I feel the critical mass of Hydras has been just achieved. And that's just six goons, that's not gonna be enough, especially because there are Zerglings abound. The Archon is nicely tanking, but it's still not enough. Oh, Locutus, what will you do? Retreating. Actually, let's look at the army. It's 20 Hydras, 30 Lynx versus 9 Dragoons and 2 Archons. Yeah, numbers are not looking as good as they did a few minutes before. Goons nicely defending. I mean, I think the goons are still cost effective, at least more cost effective than usual, but I feel the Hydro Ball is just indestructible for Locutus at this point. And it's not even that much Hydras, but there are 50 Zerlings somewhere, not here. Let's search for them. Oh, maybe they are getting dropped. I feel they are getting dropped. Oh, this is the unstoppable Doom Drop that will decimate Locutus. And yeah, let me speed this up a little. And this is definitely a drop. Oh yeah, all the Zerglings getting uploaded, and they have adrenal glands. No, not much as just one per two, but it seems to be doing well, some damage. Not that much as I expected, but still not quite decimating Locutus, but doing good work. Oh, on the contrary, this base is absolutely lost. And looking at the army tab, 26 dragoons, that's actually quite a lot. But these links are doing good works, and if you only have dragoons, that's gonna be a tough sell against links. I'm not sure I used that correctly. Please excuse me, English is not my native language, so occasionally I just say something like my hovercraft is full of eels or similar things. So, that being said, not the hovercraft, but the armies. Oh, Locutus is actually seem to have gathered the critical mass and turning this around nicely. But another Doom Drop. Will this be the final one? And I don't know. It seems no, not really. But in the meantime, oh yeah, I think Jealous just quit the game. Because I'm pretty sure Locutus didn't. So, one for the bots. And let me search for another replay. And this one is another purple wave one. Not another, but a purple wave one. And yeah, purple wave, the white Zerg. That's strange. Versus the Protoss Jealous on the top right hand corner. As usual, let's speed up the initial stages. I did not know that Purple Wave could play Zerg. I thought that was Purple Swarm, but yeah, Purple Wave always has some surprises for us. Scouting drone, yeah, and a gateway before anything else. Well, a pylon, but pylon, gateway, an extractor for Protoss. What is going on? And a quick expand on the natural for the Zerg player, which is Purple Wave. This, I feel, will be a spawning pool. Yeah, let's speed this up. Not much is done versus the scouting drone. That might be a mistake. Lonely Zealot is just scouting, minding its own business. And look, that's a hatchery and two links. Is there any upgrades? Of course not. So engaging these Zerglings would be very unwise at this point. And the Zerglings give chase. Very nicely done. Yeah, quite a lot of Zerglings. I think it's 9 of them. What happened to one? Maybe one got killed. Nice blocking on the ramp. That's some pro level play there. Drones are coming to help, and they manage to beat back the Zergling attack. And the Stargate! Maybe we see Corsair play and just supply blocking Purple Wave, which is a very real possibility, as he basically has no anti-air. Three Sunkens, a bunch of Links, Overlords, yeah, he has no anti-air at all. So this might just work. Oh, Robotics Bay. Yeah, Reavers tend to decimate Zerglings, so that's a very good counter. If the Zerglings don't manage to break this contain until then. But they seem to be hesitant, so time is on Jealousy's side. Unless... oh yeah, a Corsair is already on the map and doing good work. And oh, purple wave just expanded to the bottom left corner. That was a little bit unexpected, but actually it wasn't at all. But yeah, and another expanse here, macroing like a boss. Oh, and the first river is out on the map. Let's see. Oh yes, that's a good river hit. And I think that's the beginning of the end for Purple Wave. He is getting supply blocked very shortly. River is dropped here soon and just killing all the workers it can. Nicely picked up. Yeah, Zerglings arrive, but too late, and they can't really do anything versus the shuttle. Nice drop play, but yeah, Purple Wave. That few Zerglings won't do much for you. Sorry, but I think this seems to be a done deal. Purple Wave just made some thingies, hydralisks, and chasing down the Corsairs, which is kind of a hopeless affair. Oh, a river drop just decimated this base. Let's go a little back to see the carnage. And yeah, we got there. Maybe I went back too far. Eventually it will happen, I know. Zerglings, and I missed it again. Yeah, you saw it. Whatever. So, prime casting right here. So, Corsair is still bothering the overlords, but Purple Wave seem to be reacting well to that. Protecting its overlords and bunching them up in the base. Not much is done versus river drops, but yeah, Jealous is just taxing the river from base to base and absolutely killing all the workers. I don't know how much kills that river can have, but I'm suspecting that's quite a lot. And just ranging down the Hydra then. Nicely done. Is that the only Hydra then for Purple Wave? Yes, it is. So that's a wise choice. If Purple Wave can't make Hydras, then basically it's free reign for Corsairs. In the meantime, Purple Wave is nicely controlling the center of the map, but the Protoss is happily mining up in two bases. No, not mining up, just mining in two bases, gathering some resources and generally being an annoyance. But it's still a 5-base Zerg, which is not something should be taken lightly. Wonder how much hit points that poor river has left. Generally, though, Purple Wave's bases are left alone, and I feel he can just outproduce this one river. And yeah, maybe Jealous is realizing that too. I mean, River Heresy is important, but versus a bot, it has limited effectiveness sometimes. And nicely just exploding all the Zerg units here. Chasing down, Purple Wave retreating. Let me slow this down. Oh, where is the Protoss going? Maybe just killing the expansions? That would be a nice move at this point. And another harassment here. I mean, bots learn hard. And just a spore colony or a few Hydra stationed here might have been wise, but yeah, you can't really explain that easily to a bot. And just going to the next base, firing a scarab, killing I don't know how many workers, and this river is quite healthy still, so nothing to worry about. Not much the shuttle, and maybe that Hydra will get it, or the next one, but it's very very low. But no, it's on the clear. Unless these Hydras will kill it. Yes, they will. Two rivers lost. Yeah, but that's unfortunate, but I think they did their job quite well. Hydra roll up here, and Oh, that's a very nice storm. Five Hydralisks just lost their lives there. But at the end of the day, it's still a 5-base Zerg versus a 2-base Protoss, and the main is mining out for Jealous, and he does not have that much in the bank. And an Archon getting made, good choice versus Hydralisks, and. Let me slow that down. Oh, a third base getting taken, and three more actually for Purple Wave. Purple Wave is macroing like a boss, but you should do it while you can. I mean, the numbers are certainly looking better for Purple Wave at this moment, but don't underestimate the power of the storms. And army count just a little bit down for Purple Wave, but it's raising up rapidly. I mean, see, he does have 8-9 bases at this point, and any macro hatches? No macro hatches for Purple Wave, but 9 hatcheries, even they are spread out in the map. That's quite enough for army production. Protoss is conserving its forces very clearly and engaging smartly on the chokes, absolutely storming and killing all the Hydras. That's nicely done. And yeah, the Hydras are just streaming in one by one, which I feel is not the best choice here. I mean, Purple Wave has the money, has the map control. He should just make macro hatches and outproduce the Protoss player as much as he can. But he's not doing that, he's just slowly gathering Hydras, which does not seem to be that effective in this phase of the game. The Protoss army advantage is more than double now, and yeah, since the third base is up, well, the first base is down a little, mining wise speaking, but two mining bases and pretty decent bank and a pretty decent army, so the Protoss player is looking better and better despite Purple Wave having far more bases. Purple Wave was a winner of last year's 2018 SSCIT, but that was the Protoss race for Purple Wave. So I feel the Zerg might be a new addition, and the level of play is might be lower than the Protoss one. But it's hard to accurately just guess that, because this is just one game, and even bots make mistakes sometimes. Maybe he didn't pick the best build or something. But the match is not over yet. There are units streaming in, but almost 100 army supply for Jealous. I think this is the turning point, or we are a little bit past that, but not much Purple Wave can do at this point, because he has the production capacity, he's just not using it very well, I feel. Units are just streaming in one by one, not making any links, basically just Hydras. Oh, and there are the links, so he is making any links, I was wrong about that. So yeah, maybe a critical mass of army is needed here, but Purple Wave is struggling to get just that. And the main base getting attacked, and I think this army group can easily take it. And yes, it just does that. Let's take a look at the upgrades. Three attack for the Protoss player, one armor, leg speed, dragoon range. I think that's shuttle speed. So upgrade wise, two attack and Hydra speed and range for Purple Wave and Overlord transport. Although we didn't really see any drops from Purple Wave, and main base just absolutely destroyed. And from that point is just cleaning up. Let me speed this up, and I'm basically calling the GG at this point. Yes, well done, Jealous. I think Purple Wave is a worthy opponent. Yeah, that's the end of the game. And let's just search for another play. Maybe the last one for today. It is a random match versus Haupen. Another one that was live broadcasted. It's the same map, it's Fighting Spirit. And I think it's a Terran-based versus Terran. Why is Terran such a hard word? So yeah, scouting going on. Okay, now we are reaching the interesting phase. So let me just slow this down. Factory for Haupen. Machine shop? Oh no, machine shop. He just cancelled the machine shop because two very angry and scary marines attacked it. Expansion for Jealous. Building a wall. Defending. This vulture is just probing in, trying to get an edge. Yeah, I remember just looking at the live broadcast of this recording of the live broadcast. Yeah, terms get confusing here, but mentally it was taxing for the human player. And he just said that maybe these bots are not at the level yet that they are a very hard opponent, but they are very, very annoying, and they are absolutely everywhere all the time, and they just demand your attention every second. Rolling up with some tanks, but Haupen has a tank of its own, and yeah, walling this up, that poor vulture just got blasted into oblivion, and a few SCVs. Yeah, another thing I remember, and it was funny because Jealous just saw a few SCVs rolling along with some vultures or tanks, and he couldn't figure out why was that. What was the role of the SCVs? And later he realized, oh yeah, they are repairing SCVs. And it makes sense because a bot has an attention span to just repair units, but a human player just make new ones and sends the old ones into the fray because you simply don't have the APM to do that. Meanwhile, some raids are harassing the tanks very effectively, I feel. I think this was the game when raid harass was going on in this place. Let's rewind a little. Oh yes. So a raid is going on, and in human play raids are not as frequently used. They are mostly just very few use cases when you want that. But as you can see, Haupen is microing this rate very annoyingly and targeting the SCV that builds the missile turret. I mean, that must be really, really annoying for a human. And of course, while he is rolling up the tanks, the building SCV just got killed, and the Wraith is just peeking at the SCVs again and destroying a few in the process. I mean, that's definitely a cost-effective use of Wraiths. And the Wraith is just going outside of the threat range and going on about its merry business. Oh, sorry. So, yeah, the harass is just continuing. Floating an engineering bay for scouting, and I don't know if Haupen does that to occupy the missile turrets, but if he does that on purpose, that's also not a very bad strategy, because floating buildings are very cheap for the HP they contain, and they take a long time to take down with just missile turrets. Not that long, but you can just pick up a few SCVs, and I think engineering bay costs 125 minerals, and if you can pick three SCVs up, or just pick out three SCVs and destroy them while they destroy your engineering bay, you're ahead 25 minerals, which is admittedly a very small amount, but in bot versus bot matches, every little bit like this counts, because you can just repeat the micro, infinitely. And I don't know what these tanks are doing in the meantime. Mostly just going on a joyride and maybe listening to some techno, judging by the vibrations. I mean, this contain is pretty good here, but yeah, Open is rolling up the tanks and just sieging up and blasting this Goliath and siege tank. Oh, but one tank is not a tank, at least not anymore. And the raid just got clogged in response of the Goliath's presence and still doing its merry business. I mean, if this isn't annoying, and then I don't know what is. And just outside of missile turret range is ranging down these barracks. It is awesome. Even if it does not win games, it's certainly a very cost-effective use of resources. At least it feels like that way. And Goliath's rolling up, and there the station Goliaths just get absolutely blasted by these few tanks. This game is getting crazy, a lot of things are going on, and it's taxing on my attention, and I can just imagine how taxing it was to play against this. So yeah, another bunch of Goliaths got lost, and this tank is getting killed by the raids, and basically a whole lot of tug of war is just going on, a scan going on, I don't know to what avail, but still, and these tanks are not attacking anything. And is that raid? Yeah, that raid is just returning home. That's not Jealousy's raid. Yeah, just don't have any raids. At this point, the army supply is certainly better for Hope. And let's see, tanks are still a little bit unsure what to do, and I feel a lot of tanks got lost in that process. But these tanks are doing some work, but Jealous has the high ground advantage and slowly just pushing here. But the game is a little bit of a standstill at this point, taking a third base. That's right about time for that. I think the main is somewhat low. Natural has right amount of resources yet, and Hau is just scouting with this engineering bay, and maybe these tanks occasionally get a shot, I don't know, I mean get a shot off. But no, the tanks seem to be out of the range for both sides, and yeah, just slowly gaining ground and not being threatened by raids as much anymore. Hau is just mining out slowly, still having the larger army, but while he can't readily replace that soon, Jealous can. So this tank on the ramp getting blasted, raids are just patrolling left and right, not getting anything meaningful done. They are just very afraid of that missile turret and occasionally getting a missile in the face. Army gathering here, third base getting saturated, and I think that fourth base command center just getting floated to the destination. Let's go back to this front. Oh, I feel there might have been an exchange here, but not much has changed. And neither player is really breaking this trench warfare here. The raids are occasionally still getting harass off, but the base is mostly covered in missile turret coverage, so that's not a problem. At this point, Jealous just decided that screw it, I'm gonna go raids with 4-star ports, and maybe my raids will beat your raids, who knows. And Hau is, yeah, actually has the natural as well, but that's mining out too. So at this point, it's 4-2 base game, and in turn versus turn, it's usually the player with the more resources wins, because these endless tanks exchanges are just so taxing on your minerals and gas that, yeah, that's the only way. Of course, I'm not an expert in pro play, maybe that's going on a little bit differently, but still. 10 count is still better for Hao, and he's almost maxed. But this tank's not doing too much sieging and unsieging every now and then, but not really shooting at anything. While these few tanks are occasionally getting a shot. Oh, and there are the Wraith contingent from Jealous, and they just absolutely killing the opposing Wraith force and going around doing I don't know what. And then some more Wraiths arrive, and I think he will just go and absolutely destroy everything with just Wraiths. I mean, that's a thing you can do, right? Yeah, waiting a little before striking. Another base getting taken. Yet another. I think, yeah, Jealous just decided I'm gonna win this by macroing harder. Which, to be fair, is a pretty great tactic in any case. I mean, you got your contain, your opponent don't really got any more money, not in the bank either. Just go for it. You can replace your rates anytime. And Jealous is maxed, Hao is not. And this is the beginning of the end. Where are my rates at? There are my rates at. And the scan going of cloak doesn't really matter because there's a missile turret. But then again, neither tanks or vultures can fire into the air, so that's gonna be their demise. Oh yeah, absolutely just killing the crap out of this ground army while sieging these few tanks up just for good measure. And yeah, I think we can just call the GG here. But it is always fun to see it play out. I'm gonna speed it up just a little. And this land army is just basically saying, okay, doesn't matter, we were here all the game, we're not gonna move for this at this point, even killing the mines for good measure. And just Hao is absolutely mined out, have no workers, army or minerals. Yeah, this is just a matter of time at this point. And with that, thank you very much for watching. There are some announcements after this, and see you next week, or in my case, in 2 weeks. Thank you very much for watching this broadcast. I mentioned that I want to share some links for you, and one of them is the Twitch channel of Jealous, who was so generous and provided us some replays this week. Also, be sure to check out the SSCIT website, which is www.sscitournament.com. If you feel inclined, just donate, it helps AI development and academic research in that area. I also have my own site, makingcomputerdothings.com, where I have a podcast called The Undermind, which is all about interviewing bot authors for Brood War AI development. I also have a series of articles where I describe how I develop my own bot. If you're interested, how could you do that? Please check that out too. Thank you again and goodbye.